Let's move beyond the book formulas and practically calculate days of inventory in stock as a component of cash-cash conversion cycle. From the volume-time-speed system, derive that in order to compute the length of turnover period for inventory in days, we need the following. For numerator, we need to take value of inventory in dollars that consists of raw materials, work in process, and finished goods. Daily demand for inventory should be in denominator. Balance sheet of the company gives us the inventory amount. In analysis practices, we see three different amounts used as daily inventory demand. Let us analyze each of them. Some analysts use daily sales for daily inventory demand figure. That amount can be easily taken from sales or revenue line of income statement of the company. Financials represent that amount for the period, a month, a quarter, or a year. So we can easily find the average daily sales, dividing that amount by the appropriate number of days in the period. By taking daily sales for inventory daily demand figure in our formula, we compare sales value at sales prices in numerator with three inventory components amounts at three different prices in denominator. Those two are incompatible. That is why we consider that method of calculation of daily inventory in stock as inappropriate. Second method suggests using cost of goods sold for the inventory demand. Cost of goods sold represents the sales volume at cost. Here we have stock volume compared with the sales volume. However, with the sales volume amount available, an analyst can adjust the cost amount to the inventory level as used in numerator. Unfortunately, that is not always possible. However, that method uses cost compare sales prices in first method. Also, cost of goods sold is disclosed in public financials and available for analysis. Therefore, we conclude this method acceptable for calculation of days inventory in stock component of cash conversion cycle. The third method, usually available for insiders only. The one uses actual daily consumption of each component of inventory. It can be extracted from the accounting journal entries of the company as a credit amount on raw materials, work in process, and finished goods accounts. Since we use the same per unit cost both in numerator and denominator, we have them fully compared. That method is precisely accurate, and we consider the one as perfect. Again, unfortunately, in majority of times, the information necessary for the calculation using the third method is not accessible for outsiders. Please click back button to return to episode choice menu.